I'm so grateful tonight that we were able to finish 3 days of Unbounded. And I know I keep repeating this line like, oh, it's like the most amazing class. Every class it is. Because every class there are new people who are there. Or there might be people who have already, you know, attended the program. But the breakthroughs that they have, I've shared some of them have posted. But ito yung sinasabi ko, like 1 weekend of you investing your life and your time, and then the rest of your, it's probably the rest of your year will never be the same again. But for many of them, the rest of their lives will never be the same again. I'm grateful also na a lot of the students, like they can't put into words how grateful they were for being in the program, for saying yes to their friends. One of them shared that I was hesitant at first because I don't really like, you know, attending programs where there's an opportunity to share because I'm quite shy. And the same person at the end of the program was just so overwhelmed, smiling ear to ear, and just so grateful that they were there. Kaya ang sinasabi ko, for those of you listening tonight, you might be going through something, and it's another weekend that's finished, but my hope and my prayer for you is that you get to connect to someone or something that can literally lift up your spirits, that can literally take you to this whole new level in your life. And this is not about proving that you can be better or that you're better than other people. It's literally changing your life experience. Bakit? This spells the difference between sleeping tonight with love, joy, peace, gratitude, and abundance. Like, just this feeling, right? Versus going to bed again with perhaps uncertainty, anger, doubt, fear, worry. Sobrang importante. And now my heart is overflowing. Hi, Suzette. Thanks for being here. My heart is overflowing tonight because that's what I'm feeling. Like, I just feel so good. I feel so grateful. And this is another miracle that is manifested for me. When I say miracle, because I know the most important thing, like everything is important, but the most important thing is really the relationships we build with people. And after this weekend, hearing the participants say, you know, well, this is, I'm trying to reach out to family. I'm trying to affirm and speak to people I haven't spoken to in a long time. And it felt wonderful. It felt great. It felt amazing. I'm just overwhelmed. And I wanted to share just really quickly for those who might catch this live or the replay, a word on vision, like creating your life vision. So one of the things that I did on day one, and you know what makes it different is the group dynamic, having people share and feeling the energy and seeing their smiles, right? So to be able to create a life vision for you today is so important. What does this mean? It just means being able to see into the future. And what if everything turned out favorably for you? Like everything you ever wanted, everything you ever needed was manifest, right? And what would it feel like if you had that perfect health? What would it feel like if you had that time freedom, that financial freedom? What would it feel like if you were able to connect to church and serve in your, you know, in your own spiritual faith? What would that be like? Well, what would it be like if you had loving, harmonious, and inspiring relationships around you? You were no longer dominated or run by fear. And literally, just in day one, you can see the transformation that people are going through. I also wasn't active Friday and yesterday because I was literally so tired after. Well, not like tired like physically, but I felt like there was just so much emotional connection with participants and the process na, and it was a good feeling. It was like letting myself, like example, how many of you magpapahinga ka na lang and there's still a lot of guilt. I think a lot of parents feel this. Nagigilty ka pa kasi pagod ka, or you know, ikaw yung nagugutom tapos uunahin mo pa yung iba, you know, and then you feel bad. And a lot of people will say, no, but I do feel good. Yeah, but then you will understand every action that you're taking, it always has a benefit for you. You know, a lot of people don't think about this. So it means it's always meeting your need, whether you're serving others or serving yourself first. It's still about meeting your need. Anyway, to be able to have a vision of your life, it's life transforming. Kasi hindi, you will not be expecting the same things over and over again. Ito lang yung alam ko sa buhay ko eh. Alam kong hindi ko na mababago to, but if you get to write it down, if you get to see it, and you have other people speaking to you and empowering that vision that you see, And it's very simple, right? The exercise is very simple, but the impact is so profound. Ibig sabihin, when you go to bed tonight, pag natulog ka, you're literally creating that dream. When you wake up tomorrow, same thing. You're taking more steps toward. Now, here's the problem. Okay, the problem is the problem. A lot of people will say, yeah, that sounds great, Pam, but I have this problem. And then hindi ka na nawala dun sa problema. Like, you're always talking about the problem, you're always faced with the problem. And then you're saying, yeah, that sounds good, Bam, you know, this vision in the future and this and that. But we're not even able to identify what it is that we want. And to know what it is that you want, that's why I highly encourage that you be surrounded by a group of people who are not dictating what it is that what life you should have, right? But it because otherwise then you will go into imperative, I should, I must, I need to, and then it feels stressful for you. And so why is that important? Because chronic stress will absolutely lead to a decline in your health. And then they realize, well, kaya pala, no wonder I've been breaking down. Yeah, you've been breaking down, as I think I posted this on Leica, because you have been living with other people's timelines and expectations for you. But to create a vision that feels good. Now, and I'll share this. So a lot of you are thinking, oh, it's nasa future pa yan. But I'm literally telling you, I'm trying to share an encouragement from class that I learned the past 3 days. If you can create your vision today, even as you are sitting in your living room or your bedroom, kung nasan man kayo, tonight, like right now, you will feel uplifted. It'll be a different life experience. What do you mean? It means you can literally, at kinikilabutan ako saying this, you can literally see, feel, hear, experience your healing, your abundance, your break. I feel like so on fire siya. I know you can hear it sa boses ko. And so people are saying, you know, like, hindi pa ba na-experience ang lahat ng tao? No. What a lot of people are still experiencing today is our lack and limitation. That's why I told yung isang participant this weekend, sabi ko, you're here 1 weekend, but the moment, and he was like one of the guys who was so grateful. He made every way, he found every way to be able to be there in the weekend. Grabe yung share niya. And one of his biggest takeaways was this: if I can change the way I see myself and the way life, this is what he shared, then I can no longer go back to who I was because I'm no longer living in limitation or lack. No longer. Now I'm living in possibilities. Now I'm directed by a vision of the future instead of being trapped by a memory of the past. And so many of us, we still don't get this. Like, no, bakit coach ako, bakit ako nahihirapan? Well, because you are still, your life experience is still being dictated upon by your environment, by people around you, by your fearful and painful past. It's still a memory of our past that is dictating our future. And unless you come and create an experience where you can interrupt that pattern, interrupt that sequence, you're always going to be recreating the same thing. Sometimes you'll think, oh, like medyo na iba, no? Then you keep going back. That we call this your default mode network. How you think, it goes back to default. It's the same thing. Like, either you win the lottery or you were involved in a crash that paralyzed you. In less than a year, or I think it was around the year, this is based on research and studies, you go back to being yung default set level mo for happiness. It's pretty much the same. It's the same, winning the lottery and being paralyzed. I know no one is going to wish that you were paralyzed, but I'm just saying, what's the point? Well, the point is, unless you are getting support in your life journey, right? Unless you are exposing, and now it's important to be. Kaya nga sinasabi ko dun sa mga nag-attend, I'm saying, the most important thing that you guys did was just to show up. For me, it's like prayer. Like, I'm praying, especially now, because like a lot of people, my friends are losing their family members and sick and all of these things. So I'm spending more time in prayer. But just the moment that you put your phone down, you're not on social media, and you just say, God, I'm here, I'm showing up. I don't even know what to pray. I don't even know what I'm feeling. Some of you don't know. Some of you're saying like, God, I'm overwhelmed, I'm tired, I'm frustrated, I'm jealous, I'm insecure, whatever. I'm fearful, I'm anxious with all these things. The moment that you just show up, I'm already guaranteeing that there's a major, major breakthrough that is waiting for you to just show up. But I think for a lot of people, you know, because like, oh, well, there's so many distractions, and then we forget our priority. We forget like the most important person also in our lives, which is you. Diba? Like ang dami mo nang inaatupag eh. Like ang dami mo nang inaasikaso. I'm not saying that's great and God bless you for that, but you forget you. But to lay everything down and say, God, here I am. Please show me. Please guide me. Please direct me into the path that you want me to take. Why am I saying that? I'm so excited for you. Because the moment that you do that and you pray it with a sincere heart, you're going to start seeing like synchronicities and miracles and things manifest for you. For me, it's literally kinikilabutan ako. Every time something is manifesting now, I'm like, oh my gosh. And I wonder, why is this manifesting for me? Why isn't it manifesting for other people? Well, other people are not asking for it. Other people will say, yeah, I can pray to God. I'll ask for something. But, you know, maybe God will be too busy. Maybe, not really that important. Or I don't really want it that much, really. And we have this one shot and this one chance to be able to ask for something. And we think like, oh, it'll be too much for God. It'll be, you know, ayoko siyang maistorbo. Really? But to be able, that's why one of the things I shared in class is, what if you started living as if all your prayers were already answered? What would that be like? Well, number one, you wouldn't be frowning now. You wouldn't be anxious now. You wouldn't be worried now. You would be smiling. Like, you'd literally be smiling. Why? Like, I'm smiling now. Like, I'm grateful. Because God knows my deepest fear and your deepest fear and your deepest insecurity. You know, and your fear for your family, your fear for your loved ones, your fear for your career, your fear for not being in a relationship, your fear for being in a relationship, your fear for, you know, and everything else in between. So my point there is, if I can just acknowledge with all honesty what it is that I really want and to boldly ask it, you know. But again, it has to be clear that this is something that you want and it's not something that the world is dictating upon you, right? And it's a little bit tricky, but once you do get it, like, oh God, maybe I just want to go to the mountains and, you know, hi Myra, take photos of birds, right? And then I say, God bless you. But now you know, and this has been, I've been hearing this the past month, we want to redefine the definition of success as being happy, as happiness. Because a lot of us, like, we get these titles, we get these achievements, why are we unhappy? Well, because we think that there are things on the outside that will bring us happiness, when in fact, it is simply us acknowledging that we create happiness inside ourselves, that it's not dependent on any. Like, what if I said, like, now, and if you're listening to this, what if I just said, now, I have everything I need now, and life is perfect the way it is, and I accept it? Well, what happens if you say a prayer like that? Then, you no longer see your life as kulang, as bitin, as wala. You start experiencing, like, wow, now everything that I need is within me now, and everything that I need is around me now. And everything that I want to create in the future is also in me. What happens there? You never go back to lack. You never go back to thinking I might not be able to make it or to create. Iba yung pag dumating ka sa space, we call this now creation space. When you are in a space of creation, I think this is now you being one with God. Not you being God, but one with God, where you know that you know a God is the source and the provider. You can create whatever you want. Good health. You can manifest healing. You can manifest, you know, all those things that you need for yourself and your family. I'm just super excited if you're listening to this. One word that you get from me tonight is God bless you and God bless your work. And I pray for abundance for you. And I pray for, you know, excellent health for you and your family. I pray for peace. I pray for love. I pray for joy. And I pray for connection for you, like with people around you. And I also pray for a breakthrough. Those of you who are listening and you're like, I need a breakthrough, I pray for your breakthrough. But remember, you have to show up. Suzette, I'm glad you're here. You guys have always been showing up. You know, for me, parang ano yan eh, there was a biblical story. I'll end with this. This neighbor was in need of like a spice or something, I think, that, or they needed help. And they went to their neighbor and katok sila ng katok because they needed help. And they never stopped knocking. They never stopped knocking. Finally, yung neighbor na kuripot o madamot finally gave in and opened the door and gave what that neighbor was asking, right? And then what was the moral of the story? Even though that neighbor who opened the door was kuripot at madamot at not very kind, he still gave it to that person. Bakit? Persistence. Oh my God, I just had an aha moment. I was telling that story, I just got goosebumps. Wow. I mean, the story just popped up sa akin ngayon. Persistence. To keep knocking, and be specific for what you ask for. What was the moral there? Even though the neighbor was unkind, was stingy, didn't want to share, that neighbor still gave to that other neighbor kasi ang persistent niya, katok siya ng katok. What more, your Heavenly Father? What more, God? You know, what more, this being of kindness and goodness who knows exactly who you are and what you need? That was the message I wanted to share tonight. Keep knocking. Be very specific. Be very bold. But also be in a space of joy, gratitude, and humility when you're asking. Why humility? Because once it's given to you, you cannot help but want to share it to other people and uplift other people. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope this helped you guys out. Thank you, Myra, for messaging, and Suzette for being here. I'll leave it up as a replay. Have a great week. Next week, I'll see you guys again soon. The program I'm running again will be in June 25, 26, 27. For those of you who want to be part of that, there's going to be more people there. I'm guaranteeing you, day one, it's going to blow your mind. God bless you, and see you guys again soon. Mm-hmm.